Let's add a new file share role into our failover cluster manager on a Windows 2019 server. This also works on older versions as well. So in the roles section, as you can see here underneath my cluster, I'm going to right click and I'm going to choose configure role. And the wizard will come up. I'll click next. And I'm going to choose the file server. Click next. Now it's giving me the option for file server for general use or for scale out file server. Now the file server for general use will use what's called available storage. The scale out file server will use what's called cluster shared volume storage. Now I've done a video in this playlist you can check out that will explain what cluster shared volumes do and how they work. Let's take a look at our storage before we do this and see what we have available. So if I go into disks, I can see that DHCP is being used for my cluster disk 3. I see my disk witness is being used for the cluster disk 1. And I see available storage for that I can use for the file share. Now, if I right click on this and I chose to add to cluster shared volumes, then I would be able to use the scale out file share. But instead, I'm going to use the normal file share. And I explained the difference about all of that in the previous video. So let's go back into the roles. And I'm going to once again right click on roles, choose configure role, and go back to that file server role. Click next. So I'm going to choose the general use file server. I'll give it a name. I'm just going to call it file. And I've got to give it a unique IP address. I know 206 is available, so I'll choose that. And if it's not available, it will warn me. Now it's going to show me the only storage that I have free. So basically every time you add a role, you've got to have storage that could go with it. And then it assigns that storage to that role. So if you don't have enough storage, you'll need to add additional storage, which basically you could just partition up a bunch of hard drives and give yourself storage as needed. So I'll click next. Now it's adding the role and it's pending. I'll click finish. And now what it's also doing is it's also adding this DNS name for file.techpub.us, which is my Active Directory domain name. It's adding that into the domain DNS server. So when users want to connect into the storage, they're going to do so using file.techpub.us or whatever it is that you call it. Let's make sure I can ping it okay. So I'll ping file. And it's already added into DNS, so we know it's working just fine. Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to right click and choose an add file share option. So I've got to come up with a file share in order to make this work. Otherwise, it's just a drive that doesn't actually do anything. Now, I've got lots of different ways I can create this. I can choose the quick share, the advanced share. If this is an application, I could do it that way. If it was NFS for Linux or Unix, I could do that. I'm just going to choose the quick. And if you choose advanced, basically you just get some more options, such as setting the folder owners for access denied assistance, and you can set up classifications and quotas. If you do quick, you don't get a lot of that kind of thing, but it's good for general file sharing, as it says there. So we'll click next. Under the server name, we're going to choose file because that's what we're using this for. And under the select by volume, if I choose the E drive, it's going to use the entire E drive. If I choose a custom path, I could use just a section or a folder in E drive. It's completely up to you. I'm going to choose the entire volume for my share, and I'm going to call it file share. So this is not the same as the name of the server or the name of the service, in this case called file. This is a share name instead. So you can see it's going to be under E shares file share. If you don't want to put it under a folder called shares, you can just delete it, but that is the default. And you can see the remote path to the share is --/ file. So that takes the place of a server name. You're using what's called a shared name instead, where both server nodes will respond to it. Then I have --file share. So click next. I'm going to choose the defaults here, but I'll explain what this is. So access-based enumeration basically says, hey, if you don't have access to this, then you're not going to be able to see it. And that really helps keep the phone calls down from people who say, hey, I see a file share that Mary has access to, but John doesn't. So why is that? So this way they won't be able to see it if they don't have access to it. Continuous availability just makes it so that the failover happens a little bit more quickly. Allow caching of shares also makes access to the file shares more quickly. And you can also encrypt data access. That slows things down a little bit, but if you need that extra security, you can do that. So click next. Now we have to set permissions. So by default, you can see the administrators have full permissions and the users are going to have special permissions, which is mostly just read and execute, that kind of thing. So let's say I'm going to add in, select the principal, type domain users. All right, I'm going to say domain users have everything except for full control. So they can do everything except for take away the ability to share. I'll click OK, and OK, next, and create. And that was quick. So now our file share is done. So how do I access that? Well, just like it said, --\, file, and then the shared folder inside it called file share. --\, file. I'll hit enter. And there's the folder called file share. There it is. Now, right now, this is mounted on the E drive that you see here. So if I double click on it, then I can see shares and look at that file share. So that's where this is mounted. So the way this works is that both nodes, file server 1 and file server 2, will respond to the name file. So if you do ping file, you don't know which one you're getting. Are you getting file server 1 or file server 2? It doesn't really matter because they both respond to it. And the beauty of the failover cluster is if one of these file servers goes down, then that role will get switched to the other file server, or now called a node, as you see here. And then that other server will pick up and serve the clients under the same name of file. So that's how you add in a file share that's highly available into a failover cluster in Windows Server 2019, as well as older versions.